Hello and welcome back to Logic Components. Today, we only have three things to cover. Not, and, or. You're watching episode 2 of Logic Components. Hello and welcome back to Logic Components. Yes, we only have three gates to look at today. Nothing extremely complicated, but in order to facilitate this, I'm also going to share with you the concept of a truth table. Now, remember in the first episode, I said that processing basically involves inputs, processes, and outputs. Also recall that logic gates only work with bits, and bits can only be 0 or 1. What this means is, if a gate takes only one input, then we can be sure that there are only a grand total of 2 possible inputs that this gate can take. Obviously, the gates we are looking at right now have a consistent output for every single input. To express this in an easy form, we actually write what is called a truth table. Well, it's basically just a table saying that for this input, I'll get this output. Now, instead of showing you an example, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to jump straight in to telling you about the first gate. Because this gate is dead easy to understand, I'm going to actually take this opportunity to also explain how truth tables work as well. So let us kill two birds with one stone by taking a look at the NOT gate. Now, in a logic diagram, we actually draw out a NOT gate to look like this. It takes one input and produces one output. And as its name implies, it's extremely simple. It is basically just an inverter. What this means is if it gets 0 as an input, it produces 1 as the output. If it gets 1 as the input, it produces 0 as the output. So extremely simple, what do you get for input? You just have to invert it, and that is the output. So, what does the truth table look like? Now, the first thing we want to consider is how many inputs are there? Well, since the gate itself actually only takes one input, therefore, there are only 2 possible inputs this gate can receive, 0 or 1. So, when given 0, what is the output? Well, it's 1, because it's an inversion. Given 1, obviously the output is 0. Therefore, the truth table looks like this. So yeah, these are basically 2 extremely simple concepts. Your NOT gate simply inverts the input, whilst your truth table simply lists out all the input and output pairs. With that, let us now extend our understanding to gates that take in 2 inputs. We start off with the AND gate. What does AND tell you? In fact, AND simply tells you that if input 1 is true and input 2 is true, then the output is true. So we look at 0, 0. Since neither of them are true, the output cannot possibly be true. Therefore, the output is 0. Same for 1, 0, and 0, 1. Remember that we need both input 1 and 2 to be true before we can have true as a result. And therefore, for both these entries, the result is still false. The only time we can have an output that is true is when both input 1 and input 2 are true. In other words, the only time we can write 1 in the output is at the very last row of the truth table. This, in a nutshell, is the AND gate. So let's move on to take a look at the last gate of the day, and that is the OR gate. Now, based on what you've seen with the AND gate, you can probably put the pieces together and guess what the OR gate is supposed to do. If input 1 or input 2 is true, then the output is true. So in your truth table, well, 0, 0 means that neither one of them are true, and therefore your output has to be false. However, for 0, 1 and 1, 0, well, one of them are true, and therefore the output is true. Now, what about the last one? Well, as long as one of the inputs are true, the output will be true. Therefore, if both are true, that's even better. The output is definitely true. And there you have it. Today we've taken a look at truth tables, as well as 3 gates. The NOT gate, the AND gate, and the OR gate. Everything we've talked about today will serve as the broad foundation for basically the rest of the series. Now, just to clarify, your AND gate and your OR gate does not necessarily need to have 2 inputs. They could have more than 2 inputs. Obviously, they cannot have 1 because, you know, a comparison needs to happen. If you have more inputs, the same kind of thinking process still applies. For an AND gate, all the inputs have to be true before the output is actually true, whereas for an OR gate, All we need is one input to be true for the output to be true. However many inputs go into each gate. Well, that basically wraps it up for this episode. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you learned something. But until next time, you're watching 0612 TV. Hello, thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, remember that I appreciate every like, favorite, and comment you give me. If you'd like to see more from me in the future, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. And for more updates outside of YouTube, don't forget to follow me on Twitter at 0612TV. Once again, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.